It was 20 years ago, but I remember Gweld very well. She was a mysterious girl. Gweld? Yo-Yo asks. So the Moonlight Witch's name was Gweld. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, or if there even is a valid pronunciation. Lodi says, I've never heard of her. They see witches never reveal their real name. I think she trusted you very much. I don't think so. Gweld must be part of her name, but her real name should be much longer and impossible for humans to pronounce. Wait, so she wasn't a human then? Lodi says, I have a question for you. Did Gweld say anything about how we could stop the evil mountain that is Galga? You can't stop the evil mountain. She said that sadly, staring at the fire in the fireplace. Lodi says, you can't stop it, so there's nothing we can do. Oh, she also said that humans could build a path of light and show it the way. Lodi repeats, build a path of light and show it the way. Chris asks, what does it mean by the path of light, Grandma Jean? Yo-Yo says, Gweld was staring at the fireplace. I think she was referring to fire. Fire, Alf says. Chris says, you're right. It must be fire. A good guess, Yo-Yo. Alf says, build a path of light and show it the way means laying fires and navigate Galga? Lodi says, I have a hope now. Did she say anything else? No, I guess that was it. Thanks anyway. If our interpretation is correct, we may be able to fool Galga into landing away from Bolt. We must go now. We must explain to King Nordic and ask him to arrange the materials we need to build a path of fire. Lodi says, I don't think the king, even though he's in town, would see us. People in high positions think they're too important for commoners. No, Al says, we will see King Nordic. Lodi says, hey, I didn't realize you were so certain about this. That's the spirit. Let's go and see King Nordic. Thank you, Grandma Jean. You may be remembered as the savior of Ambush. Don't flatter me. I just relayed the message from that girl. She always had these sad eyes as if she had been taking the responsibility for all bad things that were going to happen. She must have seen many things no one could see. Glad you could talk to her, Apaka says. We must see the king at once. King Nordic doesn't see commoners. Go back. Oh. You know, that was, I just moved and it went like that. Alf says, leave it to me. You can't enter this house. I know you were doing your job, but I want to talk to your superior. What? I can see Palace Guard Chief Latol over there. Get him for me. Do you know him? He is Chief Latol. Watch your language. Chief Latol says, what happened? You're speaking so loud. Oh. You are... Save the greetings, Alf says. We're in a hurry. Let me see King Nordic. Yes, of course. Who the hell is he? He's just letting him in. Wait there, Alf says to us. Chris says, do you think Alf will be okay? Yeah, I think so. They seem to know him. Maybe even afraid of him? Lodi says, he sounded very confident, but I doubt it. He may have been arrested, Yo-Yo says. I don't think so. He's someone well-known, I think. But who the hell is he? Yo-Yo says, there he is. Lodi says, you're a brave man to see the king in such attire. How did you... Well, that's not important. So what happened? King Nordic agreed to prepare enough torches to cover the coast of Bolt. That's great. It'll be too late if we start preparing them when we arrive in Bolt. It will take at least 6 days for us to transport the materials to Bolt. This includes the 4 days we have to wait for the ship to arrive here, and the 2 days it will then take to sail to Bolt. This is the same amount by time it takes us to travel to Bolt by land. While we are waiting for the ship to arrive, we can gather the materials. I hope Galga doesn't appear within 6 days. Lodi says, "We must pray. Are you sure there's no problem arranging the ships and materials?" "Yes. They swore to their honor." "So why don't we leave the procurement to them and hurry our way to Bolt?"
"May I say something?" Chris asks.
"What is it?" Lodi says.
"I'm tired from all this walking. Can I rest a while?"
"Okay, so maybe we are going to take the boat after all."
"That's why I didn't want any company," Lodi says.
"I agree," Yurio says.
"See?"
Okay, I guess he's agreeing with Chris then.
"We should take a rest for a while."
"What?" What's his name? Lodi thought Yurio was agreeing with him.
Alf says, "We have a long journey ahead of us. Maybe we should take a short rest in the inn."
"We've actually already done that." "I guess we're doing it again."
Lodi says, "Remember, we're just taking a nap. We have no time to waste."
"All right," Yurio says.
"Okay," Chris says.
It was supposed to be a short nap, but the four were so tired they fell into a deep sleep.
"Oh well. Who's this?"
Morrison says, "Your Highness, King Alfred."
"Hmm. Wait, what?
King Alfred? Alf? I was worried about you. I'm so glad to see you well." So Alf is a King Alfred. So what is he doing wandering around with tattered clothes?
Alf says, "Morrison, lower your voice. They may wake up."
"So where have you been?"
"After the chaos broke out in Nelva, I looked for you, but I failed."
"Well, that was because I headed in the wrong direction and went to Tatuta.
By the way, what have you been doing?"
"I quickly arrived at Tuyuyal and arranged for a return ship. As we discussed, I was tracking Galaga's destination to confirm its location."
"So you have been working. Thank you."
"Galaga is now sleeping on Rotfi Island. The scholars say the monster will continue to sleep for at least another 5 days, but no more than 10 days.
"That matches the information from the fishermen.
The ship is ready at the port. We should go."
"I've been wondering, but who are they?"
"Well, they are my friends who helped me along the way. Morrison, get the ship ready to sail out and wait for me. I'll be there soon."
"Well, I hope we're coming too."
"Yes, Your Highness."
"King Alfred.
Well, I'll be damned.
Yurio, Chris, and Lodi. Should I take them with me?"
"Yes."
"No. They have a lot of spirit, but it'll be too dangerous for them to fight."
"Hey, we gave you a lot of cool stuff."
"Especially that swordsman, Lodi. He's intense. Once he sees Galaga, he will fight to the death."
"I should leave them here for their sake."
"Okay, someone please be awake and listening to him.
We have not been together long, but this is a token of my appreciation. Forgive me for leaving my good traveling companions."
"No! Back here!"
Alf removed his ring and put it on the table.
"Wait, you have two rings. Give us both back.
And give us the steel spear, too, so we can sell it."
"So long."
"Oh, that's Grandma Jean, right? Thank you for everything."
"Oh, it's Holly, actually, sorry. Wrong house.
It is my pleasure. Take care. I shall go."
Does she know who he is, too?
Ah, damn.
"Quick, we must catch him.
I feel like I haven't traveled in a while," Elf says.
"Without a situation like this, you are very busy with the affairs of the state and have no time to travel."
"We must do something about Galaga for the people of Ambush and for those guys," Alf says.
"The army is already guarding the coast of Bolt."
Alf says, "Military force is not enough to defeat Galaga. The tragedy of Nelva attests to that. Gweld's prophecy came true. I should have met King Nordic sooner and had him plan defense against Galaga."
"Well, so that's why they let him see King Nordic, because he's also a king.
So it's like King Alfred had his own pilgrimage."
But more of a personal one, I guess.
Chris is awake, says, "Yurio! Yurio!"
"I had a good sleep. Good morning, Chris. Where's Lodi?"
"You slept too much," Chris says.
"I told you I would leave you behind if you ever be like this during our journey? Well, don't you start now. There's enough people leaving us behind. What are you so mad at me for? Alf is gone. What? Well, he's Lodi, at least. Damn, what happened? I heard at the port someone saw a big ship leave with Alf on it. He was able to sing King Nordic, and now the big ship? Who is he? Wait a minute, Chris says. There's a ring. What ring? That ring? The sparkly, shiny one? Lodi says, let me see. I remember Alf was wearing it, Chris says. Where did he go without his ring? Yurio asks. Lodi says, the surface has been scratched, but I'm sure this is the crest of Ambush. Ambush? Yurio says. Who is that man? Anyway, Yurio, keep this ring with you. Don't lose it. Yurio was handed Alf's ring. Well, he had basic rings. I guess he has another ring? I don't know the situation, but he is no longer in town. Lodi says, there's no hope for another ship. We must walk to Bolt on foot. Chris says, we must reach there before Galga gets there. Right, Yurio says, we may be able to see Alf in Ambush. Okay, Lodi says, let's go. Wow. That was an unexpected turn of events. Holly says he won't come back. I don't know why, but he said he must leave because the situation's changed. He must have had an inevitable reason, so don't hold a grudge against him. You have an important job to do, too. Good luck. Well... See if anyone has anything new to say. Are you heading for Chanom? The city is full of glitters, but there are also many troubles too. Be careful. Oh, anything new else? There is no other country where the difference between the haves and the have-nots is greater. Okay. Let's check back here. I was surprised. I didn't think any ship would come to our town, and then a big ship suddenly appeared. It was a ship from Ambush. I'm familiar with ships, so I'm sure it was from there. We have this ring. So it's not an actual accessory. Alf's ring. An old ring bearing the emblem of Ambush. Okay, so I guess it wasn't a ring that Alf was wearing. Well, we're back down to three. That kind of stinks. He wasn't in the party that long. Oh, your friend? He left aboard a big ship. There was a well-dressed old gentleman as well. Did he leave you behind? Yes. Don't rub it in. I was surprised. A galley entered the port without any prior notice. I'm sure it was from Ambush. It could have been a battleship from the Ambush Navy. Maybe. Maybe. I'll study the Moonlight Witch and write a book about her one day. I'll keep you posted. Same thing. Damn you! Get back here! This says the wrong name. I think it's supposed to be Santoth. Military ships make high waves when they enter ports. I saw your friend get on the ship. Who is that man? It was a big galley, although the size was nothing compared to Galga. Who was that masked man? Damn it. He got away, indeed. Thank you. Alright, let's continue our survey of the area. I wonder if we can talk to the king now. I'm just gonna look around everywhere first. Because these people have new things to say about the boat. Galaga chased away all fish in the port. Santoth. You're not Santosh. Must be having a hell of a time. A hell of a time, I tell you. I didn't praise you. I always forget that. I think maybe if you get the pet in a good mood, yeah, motivated to find, you know, good, cool stuff for us, maybe. That's the arms dealer. And this kid. Grandpa Rule has gone to dice to gamble. He even left his house unlocked at such a time. He must be fighting with his grandson Red, who is working as guard at the checkpoint. Yeah, I think he said that before. I hope the repair work of Nelva will go smoothly. King Nordic can't govern his country properly by staying here. I'm gonna check in there last. Oh, what? Mind potion, thank you. Are we back up to 10 mind potions again? We are, good. It's good to be maxed out. Of course, the downside is you can't get any more. Our neighbor Chanam is not even giving us food when Menoth is suffering so much. They may be a rich state, but their heart is cold. Ooh. You tell them. Oh, I remember you. So who was the man you were traveling with? How could he see the king so easily? Well, we know, but our friends here don't know. Chief doesn't tell me who he is. What? Oh, the man, you mean? Still can't get in. I can't let anybody pass without a permit. It's the king's order. Well, I'm jealous. Alright, so we're on Twin Dragon Valley. East Taiyuel and West Dragon Valley Checkpoint 934 Milos. That's not that far. Lodi says, let's keep going. After we pass the checkpoint, we'll be in Chanom, and after that, ambush. Let's see who gets there faster, Uncle Alf or us. We're also racing with Galaga, Hirio says. I predict Alf will get there faster. That's right, let's go. Look at the map here. There's a dragon checkpoint. Oh, we're full of that. Oh, they're all land penguins. Oh, here, yeah, cool. Check this out. Sweet! Have a nice flight. It didn't kill any of them, unfortunately. Finishing move on Land Penguin B, I guess. Yeah, we're down to 3 again. Stinky. I should have saved her finishing move. I guess she didn't go because the one she was going to do the finishing move on is vanquished. Let's just defeat them in normal ways here. Thank you.
We'll fight you, fine. Finishing move on Land Penguin B. And finishing move on Land Penguin C. And water balloons. Do your worst, if that was it. Okay, though, there's his finishing move. I think that's the first time we've seen that. Some organic food. Very healthy for you. That we go up? Are we going? Are we going north or west? So cheer. So now Lodi's up there, so it doesn't affect him, the cheer. It's unfortunate. If he was on Chris's other side, it would... we'd get all of us. Like he was before. Oh well. Two to go. Yes! No water balls. Lodi's about to level up. That's good news. So this is another Twin Dragon Valley. Oh, that magic. Oh yeah, we're supposed to be heading that way. So what's the other way? What's this? Oh, there's nothing here. Okay. We will engage thee in combat. Alright, well, you may have used some magic. Earth Spirit. Got defense up. Let's have him attack. Looking forward to him learning some new ones. We have earth and water. What's left is like air and fire. I predict fire is gonna be pretty cool. Fortunately, didn't kill any, but softens them up a little bit, I guess. Whoop. Oh, I got water balls. Multiple water balls. Water fight. Okay, he needs help. Good thing that missed him. Cure Lodi. They're all going after him. Miss. That works out. Now please cure him. Sweet. Lodi levels up, yay! Level 9, like the rest of us. I guess we're okay with points right now. I haven't saved for a while. Where is this? Oh, this is where we just... we're headed this way. These things will fear us now. Nothing over here, right? I think we should fight one more. I want to take some aggression out on you. Get back here. Finishing move. Finishing move. You stinker, you. ...126 damage, wow. Organic food. And Yo-Yo and Chris are getting close to level 10. I like that. I like the leveling up. Yes, I do. Lodi says, hey, wait. What's wrong, Lodi? Yo-Yo says, Yo-Yo, I noticed from the way you've been fighting so far that you don't defend yourself properly. What? Don't attack with all your might all the time. You must also learn how to defend yourself, otherwise you won't last in a long battle. Okay, I understand. Well, we have healing, we have potions and magic. Chris says, do you really? I hope it'll show in your actual fighting. Chris, you have a healing spell, but you're not casting it at the right time. Yes, she is. Try to cast a spell as efficiently and effectively as possible. Your magic power is not unlimited. Hey, we do a good job with our healing. She says, okay, with no period and proper punctuation. Yo-Yo says, I hope it'll show in your actual casting. Really? Is this the game's way of saying we're not playing right or something? Copycat, Chris says.
You may think of my advice as meddlesome, but you never know what kind of monsters you may face during your journey. The ones we've seen were pretty weak, but stronger ones are sure to give you a hard time. You must work on your own fighting style while you can.
Yes, they say. Well, I hope it'll show in your actual tactics.
Oh god.
So won't we buy... We're at this dragon checkpoint right now.
Oh wait, what'd you find?
Nope.
You mean to say we're fighting... We're gonna find increasingly harder creatures? Like this cluster bee, I suppose? So why are we talking about Yurio's defense? I was supposed to wait for creatures to come up? That's boring. And she uses her cure well. Nine damage. Actually, you could have healed Yurio and Chris before we got in this battle. We got rid of the bee, so that's not that hard at all. I'm gonna save her finishing move for like a more challenging combat. So I'm not sure what that means to us. I thought something like another dialogue session was gonna start. Because we just stopped. Missed. Yo-yo levels up! Yay! We got agility food. Chris says, here we are! Finally, I can see the checkpoint. Lodi says, we'll be in Chonom after crossing the Dragon Valley checkpoint. So is this the end of Menarth? Yo-yo asks. You're right. Oh, well, there it is. Rule says, so you say you can't let me pass. Red says, I've told you many times already. I know, but can't you close your eyes and let me pass? No. Just a little favor, please. Nope, I can't do that this time. Inferring that you can do it other times. Please, please. No way. So here we come. Yo-Yo says, what's wrong? Oh, please listen. I just want to go to Chonom. I have a permit with me. Here. But this young fellow is so stubborn, he wouldn't let me pass. That's outrageous, Chris says. Who's stubborn, Grandpa? How desperate are you to try to get the sympathy of strangers? I didn't raise you to become such a stubborn gatekeeper, grandson. So he is your grandfather? Chris asks. You are going to play dice in Chonom. I'm ashamed to be your grandson. Just quit going to the casino. Can't you see? You'll come back with empty pockets, just like all the other times.
You don't really think so, do you?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I understand. I won't go then. Are you happy now?
But then what should I do?
Do you want this feeble old man to return to Tai Yuyel alone?
There are many monsters along the roads around here. Do you want me to be eaten by those monsters?
That's not what I'm saying. Besides, you are always wandering around by yourself.
What kind of cold-hearted person are you?
I won't ask you anymore. I'll ask these people to take me with them.
Oh, are we getting a fourth member again?
What? Yuria says.
Who decided that? Chris says.
Wait a minute, says Lodi.
Do you also want me to be eaten by monsters?
Lodi says, no, we don't, but...
Then that means yes, right?
Okay. He's a member of our group now.
Lodi says, you listen. We haven't agreed to your coming with us yet.
Chris says, hey, time is running out. Let him come with us to Dice.
That's my pretty girl. I can't agree with her more.
I can't believe this frivolous old man, Lodi says.
Rule joins the party.
Red says, sorry to give you trouble. He's always like that, and once he decides, he won't back down.
Okay, I'll let you go today.
Could you please take Grandpa to Dice?
Come back before sunset, alright?
Okay, okay.
So then where's Dice? Through the checkpoint, I guess? Wait, what'd you find?
Oh no, we got mind potions. Or is it up this way?
Oh, there's nothing over here. Okay.
Found another thing.
Nope, and we're full of stimulant too.
Okay. So we're going to Dice then. Okay, Chanom is the region then. Road of Dreams. Three City Bridge. We can't get to Aldos from there. But there's Elza Beach, and then finally Bolt. Alright, I'm gonna call an episode here. We'll check out the Dragon Checkpoint, and then head along. Oh, I just wanted to... Looking at Rule, he has 69 hit points, 65 magic points. That's pretty impressive, especially for an old man. Let's, heal Yurio and Chris. And then, equipment for Rule is an oaken rod, moonlight robes, and a hemp cape. And then I guess Rule must know some magic. Okay, he's also got cure. Wait, no. He's got the canned magic that we've heard a little about. Wow. Rock shot launches rocks at a single enemy. Fireball launches a ball of fire at a single enemy. And water ball launches a ball of compressed water at a single enemy, as we've seen those land penguins do. Then we got speed up, boosts the character's speed. Attack up, boosts the character's strength. And healer spell makes enemies easier to hit, speed down. Sweet. Oh, helper spell, sorry, not healer spell. And then for finishing moves, he's got magic burst. And then skills, he's got magic up, temporary boost to magical attacks. Sweet. He's got a lot of interesting spells. Well, Chris really has to up her game. She really doesn't have much, then. Really limited compared to him. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.